Now when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was informed, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam expressed great sadness, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his hands and prayed, and thrice Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Oh Allah, I have nothing to do with what Khalid has done. Oh Allah, I have nothing to do with what Khalid has done. Oh Allah, I have nothing to do with what Khalid has done." Now the family of Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu and this tribe of Banu Jazima were enemies. What happened was, okay, once Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu's father and the uncle of Khalid bin Walid, Faqih bin Mughira, they were going to Yemen on a business trip. They were killed on the way by the tribe of Banu Jazima. Now though this tribe had killed the father of Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu met Khalid, he expressed, "Oh Khalid, it is sad. It is sad that you took revenge for something that happened in the days of ignorance. Oh Khalid, you took revenge for this after you embraced Islam, after you declared, 'La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah.'" Khalid explained to Abd al-Rahman, "I killed that man that killed your father." Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, "Oh Khalid, indeed. Indeed you killed that man that killed my father. But in reality, you took revenge of your uncle, Faqih bin Mughira, who was also killed by the tribe of Banu Jazima." Now as a result of this, words were exchanged. They began to argue. And Khalid said some harsh words to Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was informed of what Khalid said to Sayyidina Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala an, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Khalid, "Oh Khalid, leave my companions, فَوَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بَيَدِهِ لَوْ أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِثْلَ أُحُدٍ ذَعْبًا مَا بَلَغْتُمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ." Oh Khalid, I swear by the one in whose hands my life is in, if you were to donate as much gold as Mount Uhud, oh Khalid, even then you cannot equal them and reach their deeds and reach what they have done. How dear, my brothers, were the likes of Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying this to the likes of Khalid bin Walid, who himself was the sword of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who himself was a very prominent and big personality in Islam, that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying to Khalid, "Oh Khalid, that even if you were to donate gold as much as Mount Uhud, you cannot equal the likes of Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu and others." This is the position that Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu held in Islam, and this is how much he was loved by Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With this, Sayyidina Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu was very fortunate that he received this honor that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, with his blessed hands, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tied a turban around his head. Sayyidina ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu explains this. He says, once he was sitting in Quba, فأتاه رجل من أهل الأراك فسأله أن إرسال العمام خلفه. A man from the inhabitants of Iraq came to him, and this man asked him with regards to leaving a tail behind when tying a turban on one's head, what we call a shamla. Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, سأنبك عنه بعلم إن شاء الله. Ibn Umar explained that he has definite knowledge with regards to this, and he will tell him about it. And then Sayyidina Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu explained that I was part of a group of 10 that were in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fihim Abu Bakr Siddiq wa Umar ibn al-Khattab wa Ali wa Uthman wa Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf wa Ibn Jabal wa Ibn Mas'ud wa Abu Mas'ud wa Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. He says, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was there, Umar was there, Sayyidina Ali was there, Sayyidina Uthman Ghani was there, Sayyidina Abd al-Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala was there, Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal was there, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was there, and Sayyidina Abu Mas'ud and Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu were also those that were present in this gathering with Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, فَجَاءُ رَجُلٌ مِنَ الْأَنصَارِ. A man from the Ansar came, he greeted Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he asked Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَيَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَيُّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَفْضَلُ. go, O Messenger of Allah, who is the best of the believers? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained, ke ahsuluhum khulqa, that the best of the believers is he who has the best character. He thereafter asked Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya Rasulullah, ayyul mu'minina akyas, who is the wisest and the cleverest out of the believers? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained, ke aksaruhum lil maut dhikra, wa ahsanuhum lahu isti'dada, ulaika humul akyas. Okay, the one that remembers death the most and makes preparations for death, these are the cleverest and the wisest of mankind. Now the man finished, and after he'd finished, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned to the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala nujma'in, and Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya ma'shir al-muhajirin, khisalu khamsin, wa'udhu billahi an tudrikuhunna. Okay, O group of muhajirin, there are five things, and I seek Allah's protection that you encounter any one of these things. لم تظهر الفاحشة في قوم قط حتى يعلنوا بها إلا فشا فيهم الطاعون والأوجاء التي لم تكن مضض في أصلافهم الذين مضوا. Adultery does not spread amongst a people except with it comes plague and illnesses which were not there before. نبي كريم صلى الله عليه وسلم said, okay, when the people do not give the right measure and weight when they buy and sell, then there is drought and the leaders will oppress. وَلَمْ يَمْنَعُ زَكَاةَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ إِلَّا مُنِيَ الْقَطْرَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَلَوْلَ الْبَهَائِمْ لَمْ يُمْتَرُ. And when they do not give their zakat, they do not take out their zakat from their wealth, then they are deprived of rain, and had it not been for the animals, then it would not rain at all. When they break the commandment of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends upon them an enemy from other than them. And when the leaders do not rule by the book of Allah, then the troubles are between them. After this, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala to prepare and get ready for an expedition to Dawmatul Jundal. Now Sayyidina Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu came in the morning and he was wearing a black turban. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the turban off his head, and the Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tied the turban around his head again, this time with his blessed hands, leaving the tail hanging behind around four fingers length. Then Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Abdul Rahman ibn Awf, O Abdul Rahman ibn Awf, حَكَذَا يَبْنَ أَوْفَ فَأْتَمْ فَإِنَّهُ أَعْرَفْ وَأَحْسَنْ O Abdul Rahman ibn Awf, this is the way to tie the turban, it is better. Then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Sayyidina Bilal al-Habshi radiallahu ta'ala anhu to give Abdul Rahman ibn Awf the flag. Praising the Almighty Allah, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خُذْ يَبْنَ أَوْفْ وَعَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ يَبْنِ أَوْفْ Take this flag, اُغْزُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا قَاتِلُوا مَنْ كَفَرَ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا تُغُلُّوا وَلَا تَغْذِرُوا وَلَا تُمَثِّرُوا وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا وَلِيدًا فَهَذَا أَهْدُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَصِيرَةُ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِيكُمْ Go in the path of Allah. Fight with those who do not believe in Allah and His Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. But make sure you do not deceive, you do not mutilate, and you do not kill a child. This is the order of Allah and His Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. When Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu got to Dawmatul Jundal, he conveyed the message of Allah in such a beautiful manner that the leader of the tribe, Isbat ibn Amr, who was a Christian, he embraced Islam and he also gave his daughter in marriage to Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Not only did Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu receive this honor, that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his blessed hands tied the amama around his head, tied his turban for him, Abdul Rahman ibn Awf radiallahu ta'ala anhu was very fortunate that out of all the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'een, other than Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was the only one to lead Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in prayer.